there. We have our tester beeping there on the outlet that we're going to be putting in the wall. Okay, so we're going to put this outlet up on the wall here, so we make sure our power is off and drill.
Is it in a bag?
Yeah, I think it's in a bag.
So which light did it take?
It didn't take any lights off.
It's by itself?
By itself.
It must be by itself. Where's it?
On the plate. I looked in those bags. It's not in any of those bags. So we pulled up our slack here. We'll cut our wire.
Oh, right here you need?
That metal plate, yeah.
Yep. No, it's hiding someplace.
Okay, so we'll cut.
Here we go.
Okay, good, thanks. Okay, nice, nice, nice. And then two fairly large, like, roofing nails.
I got roofing nails.
Okay. So we'll make sure we get wire back into the wall here. Okay, I'm going to have to push this down a little bit further and drill down. Yeah, make that hole up bigger down below here. Because I got to get that in the back in the wall here. Yeah, let's see if that goes back into our wall here. Okay, I didn't hit the side of the wire there. I'll take a screwdriver and just make sure our path is opened up there. Pull our wire back up and get it back into the slot here. So it's back in the wall 100% there. And we'll put a plate over this wire here so that a nail doesn't get pounded into it. So now we'll get our staples and our hammer. We have it back in the wall here. We'll bend it down. Yep, it's gonna be perfect.
Okay. Deep, big enough? Or these smaller ones?
Those would be perfect. Yes.
Perfect? Just enough?
Yes, perfect, perfect, yes.
Okay.
Okay, so we're gonna put our box up here. Okay. And there's our mark. Okay, I'll put it on so it's just the right height for our sheetrock right there.
Even just enough.
Just enough, yeah.
Huh?
Yep.
Perfect.
Nice. Now we'll take our knife. Oh, can you look for my knife? I keep losing that knife. Oh, never mind. It's right here.
I knew it had to be in there someplace. Yep.
I'm used to losing it all the time and not knowing where it is.
As you always say, if you lose it, well, don't worry about it.
Just go buy another one.
Buy another one. Yeah. Well, look at them. All the lights I got in here now.
Yeah, nice and bright, isn't it?
Beautiful. So that's all that was the switch was off.
Yeah. So I'll take. Can you look in the camera and see if you can see the top of the box there?
Oh, you're top of the box. You can't.
I can't.
No.
Okay, I'm gonna move it up.
Move it up more.
Okay, we'll close the screws we're not going to be using here. What do you think you'll be plugging into this outlet?
I would just do any switch or any plug if somebody wanted something that's over there, because they only have is that one over there in the corner.
Okay, now do you have a GFI since this is within 6 feet of the door?
Yeah, I have another one over here for you.
Okay, yes, we need a GFI. Okay, now we're going to put a plate on this to prevent the nail from hitting the wire.
Yep, a good thing about a 3-pack.
Okay, so since this is in a bathroom or within 6 feet of a sink, we have to put a GFI here. Okay, so we'll take our, we have where it says line and load, and this is, we're just hooking up to the line side, so we're going to hook it up here. Okay, here in the country I was born in, our white is neutral, our black is live. And our bare wire is the ground.
When you get done, I'm going to ask you a question.
Okay.
And I want to steer a bit over there.
Okay. Just close our load screws and turn it. Using them, we'll put our ground under the pressure plate and see the copper goes down to the bottom there. Make sure it's tight. We'll come up here. We'll get our white. Make sure it's not stripped too long. Okay, that's slightly long because see how much copper we have up there? We're just going to take a little smidgen off. Okay, we got our insulation butting up to just the bottom of the plastic, and our copper is going through the under the whole entire pressure plate there. All right, and we'll bring our black one over here. We'll put that on the, see it's the black screw here. We'll check our distance and length. Okay, it's a little long, so I'll cut a little off of here, like that. Make sure our wire is nice and straight here. Get it nice. Get under our pressure plate all the way. Get our insulation just up to the back there. See, our copper is bottoming out at the bottom there, and our insulation is not under the plate there. Okay, make sure it's nice and tight. Get our paper out of here. Okay, now we'll fold our wires into our box. We'll keep our ground wire down. We'll fold our black and white down so this goes into the wall nice and easily like that. Okay, we'll just screw it in. How do you like how that came out?
Beautiful.
I'll screw this in. How does it look in the camera?
Beautiful, yep.
My face and everything's in it, but face, not in it, but
nope. But your plug in the box is perfect.
And my hand's doing the work.
Right, same thing. Perfect.
Before I go, I want to write down the model number of the light and ceiling fan to put in the title.
Okay. This other thing, I don't know what's that globe for. This one.
Oh, that's the light we took down.
What is it? What?
That was for the light we took down.
Oh, that's what it was.
Okay, and there we are. It's all done. I'll put my tools into my new pouch here. I just bought this new pouch. I really like this.
And what is that plate now down below?
Now, this is a plate so that if when they're hanging sheetrock, they don't put a nail into a wire.
Okay, I see what
you
mean.
Or a sheetrock screw into a wire.
Okay. So I want to know.
Mm-hmm.
That's what that was for. Then I got a nice plug over here in this side.
Nice.
In case I wanted to do something, or you never know what you need another plug.
Yes, with here in the country I was born in, our outlets are polarized. White goes on the silver colored screw, the wide slot. Black goes on the brass colored screw, the narrow slot. And the ground goes on the green screw, and it goes to the ground hole. Black is live, white is neutral, the bare, the green is the ground. And also red and blue are live colors. And we use a 12 American wire gauge on 20 amps, 14 American wire gauge on 15 amps. And you may find white live in a switch loop or a 220, 240 volt circuit where the appliance does not require a neutral. So they make backstabs here on these receptacles, but I don't like them because it doesn't make a very good connection because it can wear out and get hot in there. So I like to put the wires on the screws.
Right, that's what you always say too.
Yes.
I know that.
Okay. I'm gonna pause it.
Okay.
Okay.
Gotta wait till they get out.
Alrighty, so how does everybody like everything?
Beautiful. Got a lot of lights, a lot of plugs, everything.
Yep. Nice fan.
Mm-hmm.
That's gonna
be very nice. Bathroom.
Take the job, David.
All righty.
Good time. Good. At peace.
Peace. Thanks for watching.
He said he has 2 million views.
Over 2 million.
He does it. He does everything. Is I watch him every time he's on.